Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Rinat, Jumabayev and David Gavrilescu. This amazing chess game was played in Moscow in 2019. Rinat, Jumabayev had white pieces and he started with c4, the English opening. Maybe e6, knight to f3, d5, white to move, e3 was played. If d4, we would have a transposition to the queen's gambit. e3, knight to f6, b3, bishop to e7, bishop to b2, David Gavrilescu castled kingside, knight to c3, d takes on c4, bishop takes on c4, c5, white to move. This is very interesting moment of the game. Castling kingside comes to mind, do you agree? There was a surprise. Rinat Jumabayev played h4, feeling adventurous and playing in the style of the great Alexander Alekhin. Knight to c6, and now queen to b1. What is white's plan? Maybe knight to g5. Player with the black pieces played knight to d5. No longer defending g4 square and daring white to play g4. Perhaps black is hoping that white would castle the queenside and then he would attack on the queenside with the pawn storm. g4, f6, and now queen to e4, knight to c7, white to move, and there was already a big surprise. Anyway, what would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Rinat Jumabayev played this amazing move, knight to g5, threatening queen takes on h7. Checkmate. Of course, he is sacrificing the knight for the attack. F takes on g5, h takes on g5, threatening queen takes on h7, checkmate. g6, problem solved. What did white get for a sacrifice piece? Well, he got a pawn and an attack, maybe. Yes, he does. First, he had to defend the pawn on g5, f4. Rook to f7, defending the weak pawn on h7. White to move. And believe it or not, to play a killer move. The killer move is a bit hidden. So, I will not even ask you to pause. Are you ready to see the killer move? The killer move is knight to b5. Now you think, what kind of a killer move is this? We will see shortly. Black to move. Bishop to f8 was played. Knight takes on b5, loses very quickly. Back to our game. Bishop to f8. Knight takes on c7. Queen takes on c7. White to move. Please pause and find the best move for white in this position. Did you pause? What did you find? Did you find this amazing move? Queen takes pawn on g6, check. What a move. Rook to g7. If h takes on g6, rook to h8, check, mate. And let's go back to move 15. This is the position, remember? White played a kill move, knight to b5, unleashing the deadly dark squared bishop. If knight takes on b5, then queen takes on g6, check, winning the game. That is why bishop to f8 was played. And let's go back to our game at move 17. So we have check. Rook to g7, blocking. If bishop goes to g7, then rook takes on h7. So we have rook to g7, threatening to take the queen. Queen to e4. Knight to b4. White to move. Bishop takes rook on g7 is tempting, isn't it? Rinat Jumabayev played g6. H takes on g6. This opens the file for the rook. White to move. How would you continue now? Rinat. Jumabayev played the obvious move. Bishop takes on e6 check. Bishop takes bishop. Queen takes on e6 check. Queen to f7 blocking. If rook to f7, then rook to h8 checkmate. So we have queen to f7. It is white to move. White played the move and black resigned. And the move is... what is the move? Rook to h8, player with the black pieces resigned in view of this continuation. King takes rook. Queen takes on f7. And for the entertainment purpose, I will show you just one line. Knight to c2. King to d1. Knight takes on a1. Bishop takes on a1. Rook to d8. f5. G takes on f5. G takes on f5. King to h7. Bishop takes on g7, bishop takes on g7, queen to g6 check, king to h8, f6, bishop takes on f6, queen takes on f6 check, king to g8, and now white plays the obvious, queen takes rook, and I guess we can stop here. How many moves did you guess? What do you think of this game?
And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.